Hey friends, it's Brecky from Sustainable Prepping, your home for fear-free emergency preparedness on the internet. And today we're going to be talking about perhaps the single most overlooked skill that you need to have in place for an emergency. If you're new here, I just want to say a great big welcome. I'm so glad you found our slice of the internet. If you're not new here, welcome back. Today we are in my den because I am talking about cleaning and cleaning routines. Now you might think, what on earth does any of this have to do with emergency preparedness? And why am I spending my time on this? But I've been in the emergency preparedness community for a while. And while there's a ton of talk about sanitation and about cleaning water, cleaning wounds, keeping your space clean is rarely at the top or even middle of a priority list. This is because cleaning and cleaning routines is something that's gone by the wayside. Long before I went to graduate school, I trained as a historian and I grew up as a living history reenactor, so I know a ton about early American history. And if you go back and read primary documents, for young women, there were all kinds of manuals for keeping the house clean and these schedules for things that needed to be cleaned. In fact, large households often had dozens of staff, in part for cleanliness. Now we live in the modern world with all kinds of excellent conveniences like washing machines, which mean we don't need three people to wring out our laundry, but it does help us understand the importance of keeping a space clean. The whole old adage of spring cleaning is important and it has a purpose, yet most of us just think of it as a time to declutter. But back in the 1700s, 1800s, spring cleaning was about airing out the house, washing all of the linens, making sure you wash things like curtains, making sure you got down to the baseboards. You literally would wash the walls, unless they had certain kinds of wallpaper, to clean out the germs of winter and freshen the entire environment. What this means for us is that cleanliness was a really key priority. It also meant that they understood, even if they didn't know what germs were, that things could accumulate. Germs and dust is made up of like hair particles and skin particles and all kinds of ickies, right? If those things accumulate, they can actually cause bacterial or mold growth, all kinds of ickies that we don't want, right? We don't want our space to be dirty. So if we jump to a future potential emergency situation, we need to know how we need to clean our homes to maintain a clean and a safe and a sanitary environment. Now, I am not talking about simply sweeping your floors and mopping and doing a once-over on the potty, right? Like, I am talking about what does it mean for us to have a plan in place and a routine in place to keep our space really clean. I've lived in the developing world and cleanliness really does dictate almost social status. The cleaner your home is, you know, the more welcoming it is. And it's not an aesthetic Pinterest kind of cleaning where there's a lack of clutter. It's really that, how clean are your floors? Can you walk barefoot in someone's home and not track dirt, right? How clean is their kitchen area? How sanitary is their kitchen area? Because any little bit that can prevent bacteria or mold, but can also prevent pests. We have to remember that there will be lots more buggies and rodents and other creepy crawlies that will be wanting to enter our homes, particularly if there's been major natural disasters, particularly if we can't get to the store for our modern convenience bug sprays and rodent traps and things. So having a cleanliness plan, having a routine, knowing how to clean your house is really important. If you are lucky enough to have a cleaning person come and tidy for you, ask them what their routine is. Not in a, you know, an accusatory way, but just ask, like, what do you do? You know, what would you do in your hour or two of cleaning? What's your routine look like? What are your hot spots? What are the areas that you think people overlook? What supplies do you use? Make sure you know what all of that is. If you don't have someone that cleans your house, like me, I am the cleaner of my house, right? Learn a system. I know that that's really hard for me as a working parent with four kids, is how do you fit in a good cleaning schedule around your busyness? But if we take a note from history, people, primarily women, spent huge amounts of time cooking food and cleaning. And yes, it's because there weren't modern conveniences, and we can talk about sexism and gender roles. In addition, it's because they knew and they understood the importance of a clean environment. Now, cleaning can be everything, like I said, from sweeping and mopping to keeping a bathroom clean. But it's also looking at things like dusting that I know as a millennial, I don't even think about dusting until it's a disgusting pile. But staying regular on dusting and keeping your baseboards clean and really, really staying on top of your crumb management. With four kids, we get crumbs everywhere, but if we're not on top of crumbs and spills and drips, that just invites, it's just a little signal to buggies, you know, to little bugs, insects, rodents, that there's food here. And when you don't have the option to go get, you know, a spray or something from the store, you prevention then becomes the key. So staying on top of all of that, having a system in place to kind of keep that at bay. This also comes to keeping, you know, cabinets clean and under beds clean and monitoring your windowsills for cracks and for mold that forms. This is about keeping the grout in your bathroom clean. Is this fun? No. Is it sexy? No. And this is why I don't think we're hearing about this in the emergency preparedness community. It is so important for you to have this skill and the routine and the know-how to even know what to clean and how to clean it appropriately. Now, this is not a how-to video. I'm not going to show you 101 ways to clean your house. If you are interested in some videos like that, tell me in the comments. I will make those if there's an interest. But really, I wanted to acknowledge this and point this out. We talk about having plenty of food storage. We talk about having plenty of first aid. We talk about water. We talk about sanitation and having an emergency toilet. And we don't talk about those day in, day out routines that will hold you in a major emergency. You need to be able to manage your pests, right? Bugs, you know, ants, spiders, other bugs, any kind of rodent, little mice or other things that might get in there, cockroaches if you live in an area where that's a problem. You need to know how to manage that. And part of the best way to manage it is prevention. Keep your house clean so it's not inviting for those kinds of pests. Pests carry disease, right? Black plague was carried on fleas on the backs of rats. And if we can keep a pest-free home through prevention, man, it's gonna be worth a pound of cure. So keep this in mind as you are doing your emergency preparedness. Keep this in mind as you are making plans with your emergency preparedness. Have a cleaning routine. Have a plan in place for how you will manage your household and who will manage your household and the supplies you need to manage your household to prevent pests, to prevent bacteria and mold growth, to keep your home as clean as possible, even cleaner perhaps than you keep it on a day-to-day basis. I know this was not a sexy video, but I am glad you stuck around for it. Let me know down in the comments if you have a cleaning routine, if you've thought about this as a part of your emergency preparedness plan and how you're gonna take action. I would love to hear what you guys are doing because I know that that is an area of growth for me personally because I don't like cleaning, so it's something that I'm still learning how to manage and manage well. I hope you guys are all doing well. Don't forget to like this video. Subscribe to this channel to never miss any of our fear-free emergency preparedness content. Come and find me over on Instagram and Facebook. I'd love to see you and get to know you more. And until the next video, happy prepping.